tears or nightmares to white parents whose worst fear is a child with dyed hair and who likes earrings. Like whatever they say has no bearing. It's so scary in a house that allows no swearing to see him walking around with his headphones blaring, alone in his own zone, cold and he don't care. He's a problem child. And what bothers him all comes out when he talks about his fucking dad walking out. Cause he hates him so bad that he blocks him out. If he ever saw him again, he'd probably knock him out. His thoughts are whacked, he's mad, so he's talking back. Talking black, brainwashed from rock and rap. He sags his pants, blue rags and a stocking cap. His stepfather hit him, so he socked him back and broke his nose. His house is a broken home, there's no control. He just lets his emotions go. With gangsters in the land of the killers, a sinner's mind is a sanctum. Only an unholy, only have one homie, only this gun, only cause don't anyone know me. Yet everybody just feels like they can relate. I guess worlds are a motherfucker. They can be great, or they can degrade, or even worse, they can teach hate. It's like these kids hang on every single statement we make, like they worship us, plus all the stores ship us platinum. Now how the fuck did this metamorphosis happen? From standing on corners and porches just rapping to having a fortune, no more kissing ass. But then these critics crucify you, journalists try to burn you, fans turn on you, attorneys all gonna turn it through to get their hands on every dime you have. They want you to lose your mind every time you mad, so they can try to make you out to look like a loose cannon. Any dispute won't hesitate to produce handguns. That's why these prosecutors wanna convict me, strictly just to